the dark horses has risen up from the World Cup qualifiers to one of the most dangerous teams in the World Cup. That is West Indies. They had to play the World Cup qualifiers before coming into the World Cup. Didn't get the direct qualification. Yes, Sri Lanka got the direct qualification, but West Indies didn't get it. They had to fight for it. They had to play with teams like Zimbabwe, Scotland, Ireland, and Afghanistan qualified into the World Cup. It was not easy for a team like West Indies, who have been dominating the cricket in the 1980s, and then they have to 70s and 80s, they were dominating the legends. There were so many legends, they're the best in the world. But then what happened here was that in order to qualify for the 2019 World Cup, they had to go through qualification, they had to go through that long distance. But yesterday they showed who they are. That powerful team showed who they are. So the second match of the Cricket World Cup 2019 was played between West Indies and Pakistan. Winning the toss, West Indies decided to bowl first, and what happened was Pakistan, one of the most unpredictable teams, Pakistan on their day can be deadly, can be very dangerous. They are a team that can beat the top teams of the world, yes. And then they are a team that will even lose to low teams. That is West Indies. So what happens is, what happened was, Pakistan was 105 for the loss of 10 wickets in 21.4 overs. They were bundled out, they were bowled out. The pace attack, the bounce of the West Indies bowlers did it to the Pakistan batsmen. They were all out for 105 in 21.4 overs, with Fakhar Zaman scoring 22 runs and Babar Azam scoring 22 runs. So they were the highest run scorers. For West Indies, it was Oshane Thomas, who took 4 wickets for 27 runs. Then Jason Holder, 3 for 42. And Deras, 2 for 4. Excellent bowling figures. Excellent bowling from the West Indies bowlers. The chase was a very easy one. You know, West Indies scored 108 runs in just 13.4 overs, and they lost 3 wickets. Chris Gayle top scored with 50 from 34 deliveries, and Nicholas Porran was not out on 34 from 19 deliveries. All they took was 13.4 overs, and it was a comprehensive, easy victory for the West Indies. They won by 7 wickets. Mohammad Amir took all the 3 wickets. And one thing that happened in this match was Chris Gayle went into the history as the player to score the most number of sixes in World Cups actually. 38 sixes. The previous record was held by AB de Villiers with 37 sixes, and now Chris Gayle has scored 38 sixes. Yes, that's something remarkable. In World Cup cricket, he is the highest sixes scorer. Yes, there's more to look forward about West Indies. This team is really, really doing well. And let's see what happens today between Sri Lanka and New Zealand. Another team that is rated very low by the critics and by everyone. Let's see how Sri Lanka will perform today. And hopefully, yes, we had to prove a point to Brendan McCullum. And then Ian Smith, who has been, you know, bugging us, you know, joking to us. And then there is Ian Morgan as well, who has been sarcastic and, you know, saying that we are a surprise pack. Yes, we are a surprise pack, and we have to prove everybody that we can beat matches. We are still the same champion team. That's what people have forgotten. They have forgotten that we were once world champions. That from 2007 to 2014, we have been in 5 ICC championship finals, five World Cup finals, 2 50 over finals and 3 T20 finals. People have forgotten that. Now it's time to prove who we are. So let's see what happens in today's match. Thank you.